Hello friends, welcome to AIIMS Today YouTube channel. In this video we are going to discuss about IIT JEE NEET Foundation Chemistry Chemical Bonding chapter from this about valency bond theory. This theory was proposed by scientists Hitler and London in 1927 to explain how a covalent bond is formed. Later this theory was extended by Pauling and Slater in 1931. So the main postulates or points of this theory are: a covalent bond is formed by overlapping of atomic orbitals of valence shell of the two atoms. Only half-filled atomic orbitals, that is orbitals singly occupied, can enter into overlapping process. The resulting bond acquires a pair of electrons with opposite spins. The atoms with the half-filled orbitals must come close to one another with their axis in proper directions for overlapping. Greater the overlapping, higher is the strength of the chemical bond formed. So dumbbell-shaped p orbitals will form a stronger covalent bond as compared to spherically symmetrical s orbital, as the extent of overlapping is greater in p orbitals than that of s orbital. And hence the covalent bond formed by p orbitals will be much stronger than the covalent bond formed by s orbitals overlapping, because the extent of overlapping is greater in case of p orbitals. Now here we can see the order of the strength of the extent of overlapping is shown here. So the extent of overlapping is greater in case of pp orbitals overlapping than in other cases. Based on the difference in the overlaps, covalent bonds are of two types. They are sigma bond and pi bond. Let us say first about sigma bond. The covalent bond formed between two atoms by the end-to-end or axial overlap or face-to-face overlap of half-filled atomic orbitals along their axis is called sigma bond. A sigma bond is the first bond formed between the bonded atoms. That means when two atoms approach each other to form bonds, first a sigma bond is formed. Sigma bond is a strong bond because the extent of overlapping between electron clouds is maximum. A sigma bond may be formed between the atoms by SS overlapping. That means S orbital of one atom overlaps with S orbital of another atom to form a sigma bond. This kind of sigma bond formed is called SS overlapping sigma bond. This sigma bond also may be formed by SP overlapping. That means S orbital of one atom overlaps with P orbital of another atom to form a sigma bond. This is called SP overlapping. So this sigma bond also may be formed by PP overlapping. That means the P orbital of one atom overlaps with P orbital of another atom to form a sigma bond. This is called PP overlapping. So in these ways, a sigma bond may occur. Let us see first among them SS overlapping by taking one example, that is the formation of hydrogen molecule. In this, each hydrogen atom has one electron in its 1s orbital with which is being spherical. 1s orbital of both the hydrogen atoms approach each other closely. When they reach a point of maximum attraction by the two nuclei, they overlap and form a sigma bond. Here we can see each hydrogen atom has one electron in its spherically symmetrical s orbital. So when these two hydrogen atoms approach each other, these s orbitals overlap each other and they pair their electrons, and hence a sigma bond is formed. This is called SS overlapping. So you can say in a hydrogen molecule, sigma bond is formed by SS overlapping. The bond has two electrons which have opposite spins. The probability of finding these electrons is maximum in the region between the two nuclei of the molecular axis. So the finding of probability of this pair of electrons will be maximum in this region, which is being in between the molecular axis. Next, let us see about sp overlapping by taking the molecular formation of hydrogen fluoride. As we know, fluorine has the valence shell configuration as 2s2 2p5 or 2s2 2px2 2py2 2pz1. It has one singly occupied orbital 2pz, 2pz1. This 2pz orbital of fluorine overlaps with one s orbital of hydrogen to form a sigma bond. Here you can see one s orbital of hydrogen overlaps with singly electron occupied 2pz orbital of fluorine to form sp overlapping and hence a sigma bond. Other examples for the molecules having sp overlapping are H2O, that is water molecule, ammonia, NH3 molecule, etc. In these also, the s orbitals of hydrogens overlap with p orbitals of central atoms oxygen and nitrogen respectively to form sp overlapping sigma bonds. Next, let us say about pp overlapping by taking example F2 molecule. In the formation of F2 molecule, the electron configuration of fluorine atom is 1s2, 2s2, 2px2, 2py2 and 2pz1. That is, one orbital is singly occupied, that is 2pz1. When these p orbitals of two fluorine atoms approach each other with their heads directly towards one another, they overlap and form a sigma bond. So 2pz orbital, which is having a singly occupied orbital, overlaps with the 2pz orbital of another fluorine to form pp overlapping and hence a sigma bond. Other examples for the molecules having pp overlapping are chlorine molecule, nitrogen, oxygen, etc. These also contain pp overlapping sigma bonds in them. Next, let us say about pi bond formation. The covalent bond formed by these sidewise overlapping or lateral overlapping of atomic orbitals is known as pi bond. Pi bonds are formed by these sidewise or lateral overlapping of p orbitals. So this will be formed once after formation of a sigma bond. The overlapping takes place at the side of two lobes and hence the extent of overlapping is relatively smaller when compared to the sigma bond form. Thus, pi bond is a weaker bond in comparison to a sigma bond. The molecular orbital is oriented above and below the plane containing nuclear axis. So, pi bond is formed in this way. These loops are overlapped sidewise to the nuclear axis. So, hence, overall extent of overlapping is less and even the strength of the pi bond is also somewhat less when compared to sigma bond. Next, let us see about polar and non-polar covalent bonds. The covalent bond in which a bonded pair of electrons is equally shared between two atoms is known as non-polar covalent bond. It is also defined as the covalent bond formed between two similar atoms or atoms with the same electronegativity is known as non-polar covalent bond. Means the covalent bond, if it is formed between the atoms of same electronegativity, then the bonded pair of electrons are pulled by the two atoms equally. Hence, they will be equally shared. Hence, there is no formation of any charges on them. Here, polar represents charge. As there is no formation of charge, hence the molecule or bond formed is called non-polar covalent bond. For example, in the homoatomic molecules like H2, the shared pair of electrons are equally attracted by the two atoms. The bond so formed is called non-polar covalent bond. We can see here both the hydrogen atoms are forming a covalent bond by contributing one electron each and hence they are sharing a pair of electrons. Here both are the same atoms or having the same electronegativity, hence they pull the electron pair equally towards both. So this pair of electrons are shared equally by them, hence no formation of any charge on them. That is why this bond formed between these two is called non-polar covalent bond. More examples for the molecules having non-polar covalent bond are oxygen, mostly homoatomic molecules like oxygen, chlorine, nitrogen, fluorine, etc. These all molecules contain covalent bonds which are non-polar in nature. On the other hand, the covalent bond formed between two dissimilar atoms or atoms with different electronegativities is called polar covalent bond. That means if a bond covalent bond is formed between two dissimilar atoms, then the pair of electrons are pulled towards one of those two atoms which has more electronegativity and hence a slight charges occurs. That is why these bonds are called polar covalent bonds. We can see here for one example, For example, in the molecule HCl, the shared electron pair between the two atoms gets displaced more towards chlorine atom, since the electronegativity of chlorine is far greater than hydrogen. The resultant covalent bond becomes polar in nature. So here, chlorine and hydrogen contributes one electron for covalent bond formation. But as chlorine is more electronegative, it pulls the pair of electrons towards it, and hence slightly charges occur on them. Chlorine gets a slight negative charge, whereas hydrogen gets slight positive charge. So the attaining of these charges is called polarity, and hence this molecule is called polar covalent molecule, and the bond is called polar covalent bond. More examples for the molecules having polar covalent bond are hydrogen fluoride, water molecule, ammonia, etc. These also, between the hydrogen and the central atom, a pair of electrons are shared. But as the central atom is being more electronegative, that pulls the electrons towards them and results in the formation of polar covalent bond. Thank you for watching our video. Please subscribe our channel and press the bell icon for receiving latest updates.